centuries-long tradition. Along with the communion service and morning prayer, or matins, evening prayer, or evensong, forms one part of these common celebrations of the church. Choral evensong differs from evening prayer only in the fact that portions of the service are sung instead of spoken. There are opportunities for singing and or chanting from the clergy, choir, and congregation alike. The purpose of evensong is, like other worship services, to praise God. While it does so in both spoken word and song, the structure differs from that of an Anglican communion service or a Catholic Mass. In addition to a contrasting format, including a different cycle of scripture readings and canticles, the distinct element of evensong is the lack of communion. It is hard to imagine a time where evensong was not sung daily in the great cathedrals of Britain. However, that period did exist. In fact, it was a reflection of the Catholic religion of England at the time. King Henry VIII is historically well known for his split from the Catholic Church after the Pope refused to grant he and his first wife an annulment. This disagreement led King Henry to establish the Church of England and declare himself its head. The birth of the Anglican Church was an unexpected byproduct of an unfortunate blemish in the history of England's monarchy. Bishop Thomas Cranmer, a trusted ally of the king, was quietly reforming the fledgling Church of England with an aim to simplify worship. While Catholic monks would attend church several times a day, known as the daily offices, this wasn't practical for the layperson. One of the key reforms of the Anglican Church was to consolidate the daily worship offerings. This is how morning prayer, a fusion of matins and lauds, and evening prayer, which was a fusion of vespers and compline, became the two principal daily services. Additionally, Bishop Cranmer began writing prayers and services in English rather than in Latin. In 1548, he led a group of bishops and church leaders who created the first Anglican prayer book. As the church was now being governed by the state, Cranmer was able to put legislation before Parliament, which resulted in the 1549 Act of Uniformity. This act required all churches in England to use the new prayer book within 1 year's time. Clergy who refused to adopt it would face stiff penalties, up to and including their own defrocking and or life in prison. There began a period of uniformity in liturgy for the newly created Church of England. From then on, the service of evensong would inspire countless composers to write music for its use. Evening prayer could, at any time, be transformed from a spoken service to one which is sung. The principal musical offerings are the praises and responses, hymns, the psalms, and the Magnificat and Nunc Dimittis. Originally part of the service of Vespers, the Magnificat comes from the Gospel of Luke and includes the Gloria Patri. Called the Song of Mary, it has often been described as the first Christian hymn. It has been sung in Christian worship since the 6th century AD. In its text, quote, "Mary praises the Lord for his mercy toward her and the nation of Israel." It can be summarized in 4 different parts. Mary rejoices that she has the privilege of giving birth to the promised Messiah. She glorifies God for his power, holiness, and mercy. Mary looks forward to God transforming the world through the Messiah. And Mary exalts God because he has been faithful to his promise to Abraham. In the context of evensong, the Magnificat is paired with the Nunc Dimittis, or the Song of Simeon. Originally from the service of compline, this text comes from the 2nd chapter of Luke and has been sung since the 4th century AD. This is also a song of praise, though much shorter than the Magnificat. In this story, quote, "The aged Simeon had been promised by the Holy Spirit that he would not die until he had seen the Messiah." When Joseph and Mary had brought Jesus to the temple for the ancient rite of purification, Simeon recognized him, took him up, and sang his song of praise. Now, several hundred years later, the service of evensong is still a regular celebration in Anglican and Episcopal churches throughout the world. Composers from many countries and backgrounds are still inspired by these ancient texts and continue to produce new and fresh settings based on them. As evensong began as a service in the English church, it is understandable that much of the existing music for this service comes from British composers. While that music forms the foundation of the genre, there are many settings written by international composers. Today, you will hear portions of 5 canticle settings written by living American composers. The Magnificat from Stephen Caracciolo's Evening Service in A opens our performance today. Dr. Caracciolo is a well-known name to the Central Ohio area, as he founded the Columbus-based Bel Canto Singers in 1994, and now serves as artistic director for the Lancaster Chorale. Written in 2015, the piece begins with a lively 8th note rhythmic pattern in the organ accompaniment. This pattern appears throughout the movement, and again during the closing Gloria Patri. The vocal parts have their own opportunities to engage in rhythmic play, especially in the section that begins with the text, "He hath scattered the crowd in the imagination of their hearts." Stagnant organ chord, and short 1 to 3 note melodic fragments traded back and forth between the upper three voice parts. Thank you again for being here today. The musical portion of this concert.